Hello students, welcome to today's session. So in this session we are going to see about the digital sensors. So the word digital means either on or off. So digital sensor is a electronic or electrochemical sensor where data is digitally converted and transmitted. So sensors are often used for analytical measurements, that is the measurement of chemical and physical properties of liquids. So we are going to see in detail. So the digital sensors, so are the sensors in which the signal which is directly converted into digital signal output. So it senses both on and off states. So some examples of digital sensors are the door sensors, or the LED lights, alarms, push button switches, so etc. So it gives the output as ones and zeros. So one means on and zero means off. So one which corresponds to certain range of voltage, current, frequency, phase or other electronic parameters. So based on that it will give the high. Okay, so high means one. So zero corresponds to another range of voltage. So current, frequency, phase or any other electrical parameters. So for example, one which corresponds to the 12 to 8 voltage output. So and 0 which corresponds to 0 to 4 voltage output. So this is an example of a digital sensor. So digital sensor, it is specific electronic component. So it uses the sensor and associated electronic digital circuit to reach zeros and ones. So specific component which gives the digital output, one means on and zero means off state. So output of ones and zeros as a binary number which corresponds to a set of on and off states. So digital sensor which uses the associated sensor and the associated electronic digital circuit. Okay, so this circuit which gives the digital output, the output is ones and zeros. So these ones and zeros is read through a port in a microcontroller. So this sensor will be interfaced with a microcontroller or microprocessor. So it reads the value and sends the data to the microcontroller with the help of the interface. So this circuit which can be used for sensing a sudden change in specific physical state or a condition. So for example, a temperature or a pressure. So for fixing the particular threshold voltage, so and then reading the particular values. So based upon the whether it leads the threshold level or lower the threshold level. So this circuit which can be used for sensing a sudden change in a specific physical state or condition, and can be used for sensing a sudden change in a specific set. So specific set of physical states or the condition. So for sensing an on and off state, so this diagram will be helpful. Okay, so it is attached to the microcontroller, and microcontroller have a ground potential and it connected to the resistance. So with a voltage, okay. So and then it is connected to a BJT, bipolar junction transistor. So here the voltage supply, it determines on and off state. So here the number of conditions which needs to be detected using the concept of digital output on a on and off state. So for example, in four cases, how to sense an on and off state, which means binary 1 and 0 output for reading a circuit or a microcontroller. So here the first case, how is the switch which is state is sensed based upon how does the 1 bit digital output 1 or 0 will generate. So second is that how does a street light sensor which senses the ambient light condition. So another thing is that how does a rotating wheel state which senses which has reached at a specific orientation. So and then last one is the how does a linearly moving part, that is a moving part state which senses that has reached at a specific linear position. So here we are assuming the digital output is the input to the microcontroller port. So it shows that the top which is consisting of this left diagrams consisting of 1 and A, which is at a ground potential, which is the negative end of the supply, and other end which is connected to the B, which is connected to the end C of the switch. Okay, so this is the positive potential. Okay, so and then a switch which can have two states, either on or off, and gives two outputs, either 0 or 1. So the other end, which D, which is connected to the supply voltage. Okay, so that is supply voltage, which is V plus, or the 5 voltage, for example, a 5 voltage. And then a microcontroller port pins, which is connected to C and A. Next one is that the right circuit, which is consisting of BJT. Okay, so here the circuit is at the base end. So V of BJT, which is connected to the one end of the switch, and the emitter end, that is E, which is connected to the ground potential, and the collector end C, which is connected to the positive end of the supply, VCC supply. Okay, so through the resistance. So the switch, which is one end, which is connected to the microcontroller port pin. Okay, so the microcontroller port pin, other end, which is connected to the C. Okay, so this microcontroller end is connected to the switch, which is negative terminal, and other port, which is connected to the terminal of collector. Okay, so BJT collector terminal. So and then this middle circuit, which is consisting of MOSFET circuit. Okay, so metal oxide semiconductor field effect transistor. Okay, so metal oxide field effect transistor, so which is connected to the one end, which is connected to the switch. Okay, so B, which is connected to the switch through microcontroller, and then the source end, yes. Okay, so with the help of these two terminals, the microcontroller terminal has been connected to the negative potential. So positive potential is connected to the gate. Okay, so gate end of the MOSFET. So and then a drain, which is connected to the MOSFET with connected to the microcontroller pin. Okay, so and then through a resistance, it connects to the VDD, that is the voltage, supply voltage. So the gate end, which connect to the end A of the switch. So the inputs at the microcontroller port pins are from B and D. So this is the input to the microcontroller. So this circuit gives ones and zeros at port pins when switch state is off and on. Okay, so the right side top circuit, so this circuit, the collector voltage C, which is very less than 0.8 volt, is taken as 0. So and then greater than 2.8 volt is taken as 1, and the VCC is at 5. Okay, so whatever it may be, the voltage which is greater than 2.8, it is taken as 1, and less than 0.8. okay, so the collector voltage at which is less than 0.8 is taken as 0. So the middle circuit, okay, so here the voltage at the drain with respect to the supply terminal, which is less than 1/3 of VDD, the drain, and with a minus of VSS, so that is the source voltage. So VDD minus VSS, which is considered as 0. So 1/3 of VDD minus VSS is considered as 0, and greater than 2/3 of VDD minus VSS is taken as 1. So an environment ambient condition sensor at a street light, okay, so which senses the ambient light condition using a photo transistor. So these are all the applications: sensing of presence of traffic on a street, and then sensing the filling of waste container up to a certain preset level, that sends an alert through internet to a city waste management service. So and then sensing an ambient light condition, and sensing of organic vapors in presence of sensing gas leakages, and sensing for generating emergency in case of fire, okay, by sudden rise of temperature, and detecting the smoke. So here the microcontroller electronic circuit for street light environment. So this is the typical example. So where microcontroller, which is connected to the photo transistor. Okay, so here it uses the NPN photo transistor. So environment ambient condition sensor, which is used at a street light, it senses the ambient light condition using a photo transistor. So FPT, which detects the environment ambient light intensity above the threshold level. So here the circuit which gives one as an output when ambient light intensity which is falling on the phototransistor is below the threshold. Okay, so and gives zero output which where the ambient light intensity is above the threshold. Okay, so it is somewhat vice versa. Okay, so this is the monitoring of sensor through a FPT. Okay, so phototransistor. So and then microcontroller based rotating wheel. Okay, so here the electronic circuits for a rotating wheel. So here the it connected to the phototransistor which is connected to the LED. Okay, so it senses the wheel rotation for a computing the speed of the vehicle. Okay, so a rotating wheel which gives us two output, 1 and 0, when it has a pair of LED or IR, that is infrared LED, that is light emitting diode, and a photo transistor which is on the two sides of a slot in the wheel. So it gives the speed of the particular rotation. Okay, so the circuit which gives one in output when a slot of the rotating wheel reaches near the FPT, that is a photo transistor, on completing a rotation, and gives zero in output still that is revolving towards the completion of the next revolution. So this is how the speed of the particular wheel is measured. Okay, so the light which is correspond to the phototransistor does not block till the wheel completes the revolution. Okay, so this is how it take the value, it senses the value. So the microcontroller port pin, that is it receives the input 1 or 0. So the number of ones within the specific time interval which is divided by the interval which gives the rotational speed, that is revolutions per minute RPM. So the value of RPM and circumference of the tire which enables the computation of speed in kilometer per hour in the automobiles. So this is how we are getting the speed of the vehicle in the display. So as a rotatory motion which is converted into linear motion in the automobile. So next one is the microcontroller electronic circuit for sensing linear motion of a shaft. So here the moving part which is reaching at a specific location is sensed with the help of the part which is attached with a light blocker. Okay, so here the light blocker is used. Okay, so in all the applications, the phototransistor which is connected to the microcontroller. Okay, so here the specific block is used in addition. Okay, so for sensing a linear motion of a shaft using a linear encoder with scale marking. So here the part is attached with a light blocker. So when the part reaches the empty space which between the pair of LEDs, so here the LED pair is inserted, and when the part reaches the empty space between the pair of LED and the phototransistor, the blocker blocks the light which is falling on the phototransistor. So and the circuit gives one as an output. So on the circuit when it gives the zero means when the part is not in the vicinity and it is not blocking the light. So when the light is blocked it is 1, when the light is not blocked it is 0. So the sensing a set of on and off states. So a number of conditions which is together needed in the detection of for many applications. So the circuit which generates the digital output for a set of on and off states. So specific electronic components or a circuit which gives the digital output such as a set of 4 or 8 or 16 states consisting of zeros and ones for a sensing a set of discrete changes with a specific set of physical states or the condition. So the output connects to the port input of a microcontroller which reads the input at a given instant. So this is how the sensing a set of on and off states. So here the microcontroller electronic circuits for sensing on and off states. So it has shift clock and serial key data. So it has 8 on and off keys. So it and then 8 bit to 3 serial shifter. So and then microcontroller. So here the 5 arrays of 10s and then 10 NPN phototransistor and LED pairs. Each is having a 5 arrays. Okay. So and then serial data and shift clock. So here the 3-bit to 8-bit decoder. So 8 arrays of 8 pairs of photoconductors, laser lights, diodes having a this set. Okay, and detector states which is having 8-bit parallel to serial shifter. So this is how the array of 8 switches which generates set of 1s and zeros. And the communication of a number of chocolates for each type of flavors in the automatic chocolate vending machine. Okay, so it is connected through internet. So and 10% sale of each type is at each instant has been updated through the network. So how does the data of unoccupied parking slots can be identified among the number of parking slots and used in internet of parking spaces? So here this, it uses the array of 8 switches which generates 8-bit input for a port and an output port pin in a microcontroller. So it sends a signal, that is 1, and 8 which returns lines gives the input to the microcontroller port. Okay, so the 8-bit port reads the input to sends 8 on and off states. Okay, so when a keyboard is used, then 8 sense lines and 8 return lines. Okay, so these 8 sense lines and 8 return lines can be used to read the input and sense which key is pressed at a given instant. So and then here the 5 arrays of 10 FPT LED pairs, photo transistor and LED pairs. So 10% level in each chocolate filler assembly for each type of chocolate flavor. So 5 flavor assemblies means 50 sensors. So each sensor generates a on state signal 1 for 10% level of unsold chocolate type. So when a specific flavor which sells 80%, then 8 sensors which gives 8 ones and 2 zeros in an array. So the total filler levels are 10 for each chocolate flavor. That is the total sum of 1s and zeros is 80 decimal. So the 5 set of 5 filler assemblies for 5 chocolate flavors are read cyclically. So with the preset intervals. So the data of all 50 filler levels is transmitted to the internet and then a chocolate vending service application communicates regularly with the presence of unsold chocolate percentage to the service. So this third diagram which shows the parking slots, so internet of parking slots. So how the parking slots, empty parking slot can be filled. Okay, so how it can be known whether the car is parked or not. Okay, or assume that there are 64 parking slots. So a photoconductor has a sensor for laser diode light beam and it has a block detection which can be used at each parking slot. So each sensor which generates an on state signal, that is 1, whenever a slot gets vacant. So whenever the parking slot is free, it shows the on state signal as 1. So an 8 array of 8 slots is selected by 3 encoded lines which is from the microcontroller. So a set of 8 slot status in an array is read cyclically. So each array is cyclically selected. So data of all 64 slot is transmitted to the internet and then a parking service application communicates regularly at the presence of vacant slots to the vehicles, that is passing through the traffic lights nearby to the parking facility. So far we have seen the digital sensors, then sensing of on and off states applications, and then different applications using street light environment of microcontroller electronic circuit based, and then rotating wheel, and then sensing linear motion of a shaft, then sensing and set of on and off states with the help of the examples. So thank you for watching.